Showbiz Shelley here in studio with Simeon Rice, who you might know as a football player, but he's doing movies now. Hi, Simeon. Welcome.
Hey, how you doing?
Simeon? I'm doing good. You have a good radio voice, too.
If you've ever been told,
yeah.
I've heard that before.
Yeah, you have a great radio voice, so that might be the next thing.
That's cool.
But first, let's talk about this movie, Unsullied. Comes out August 28th. Mm-hmm. Crazy. You directed and wrote this.
I did.
Okay, so do you want to talk about the movie first, or do you want to talk about how you got to this point? Because both are very interesting.
Let's talk about the movie.
Okay, let's talk about the movie first. Right. So, crazy movie. How did you come up with this in the first place?
Oh, watching a lot of movies. I really did. And after watching No Country for Old Men, I said, I want to make a movie like this. I want to write a movie like this.
Why?
Because I love that suspense. I love that level of anxiety that that film created. It was an experience. I felt like I was in it. Mm-hmm. And I was like, I want to make a movie like that that gives people that like these type of films that level of stimulation, but not just 25 minutes, but for an hour and 30 minutes of a film.
So how long did it take you to write?
It really just, my process is different than most people because I can come up with a script right off the top of my head.
Really?
And yes, it just flows very effervescently.
Okay.
And I continue to add on to it over the course. And I never dictate any aspects of it. I just kind of let it breathe like a world, like a body. And at the end, I finish it in its finality as I'm on set in terms of its development.
Really?
So I'll finish a script, but I'll continue to change it. But the story will just kind of already be in my head.
Okay. Mm-hmm. And then it kind of is almost an outline and you can just go with it on the set.
Right. I'll write the script out. It's all written. But what I'm saying, I literally have the whole story in my head.
Wow. Yeah. And then you directed this too. So what is that like being a movie director?
It's fun. You know, It's fun. It's bringing your vision to life. Visual storytelling. It's something that I kind of did my whole life. I didn't know it unbeknownst to myself, but I speak from a visual picture. The way I speak is colorful. That's always been taught when I was in the NFL and doing interviews. So when I was able to put a pen to paper and create these visual stimulations and understand shot lists and go to film school, I was able to really bring it all together and make sense of it.
So that's what I was going to say. So you are a football player, formerly. And how then did you make the decision to go to film school? I mean, how did you end up making movies?
Well, during that process of being in the NFL, you want challenges. And I wanted to challenge myself. I wanted to challenge myself from a psychological standpoint. I understood what I could do physically, and I was pretty smart throughout my life. I understand I got things really good, but I really wanted to find out what I was made of psychologically. I really wanted to challenge myself. I wanted to see if I could create the visual stories that I have in my head and for the whole world can see. And so what I told myself somewhere in the great in-between of me playing in that journey, when I went to Tampa, I said, when I retire from football, I want to go to film school. That's where it all began. So I just held myself to that standard and completed that.
That's amazing because I think a lot of people aren't necessarily like you. They play football and then they retire on the money and just hang around, right?
Well, you know, everybody's different.
Everybody has a story.
Yeah, everybody is different. Everybody has a story. I think the compelling thing about this story is the theme of my life is I've always challenged myself and my teammates would expect that of me because those that know me, really, it's like we have people we know from a surface standpoint. Mm-hmm. We understand people from a plastic standpoint when we see them from afar, from what most guys do in general. But when you peel that away and you get down to the individual, you get to the core of the individual. The core of my being is always to find the challenge and to rise to it. You know, my life has been a bucket list. I won a Super Bowl. I was all pro. Won 4 state titles in high school.
Yeah.
Was Big Ten Rookie of the Year. My life has been just a fantasy ride, but it hasn't all been cookies and cream. I'm from the south side of Chicago.
That's
Roseland.
Right. Yeah.
They call it the Wild Hunters. I call it home.
That's
you know
right.
what I mean? That's what they call it now.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, so all those different seeds has been planted in my life. And I continue to go and continue to pursue. And it's just me. I'm just still that inner child in me that just want to be better than what I was yesterday. And I challenge myself to do so.
Is it crazy thinking, you know, do you get to go home a lot and then thinking about being here from Chicago and then where you eventually ended up and what you're doing now?
Yeah, because think about it. I'm all about story arc.
Yeah.
My story arc started off on 117th and State Street.
Uh-huh.
Okay. So I was much like many of those kids in that area that said, you know, I want to do something with my life. I want to be something in this world. I want to leave my thumbprint. And my backstory started with a father that worked at Ford Motor Company. Uh-huh. You know, it's just like many guys out there. My mom was a school teacher, and they just sent me to Mount Carmel, and let's become something, Simeon. Mm-hmm. And I became a great football player. I really have. And I put everything on my stock into it. And I remember the days and those when I didn't even know how to, like, I didn't even know what direction I was going in. You know, I was just driven. Mm-hmm. I was driven to be better than I was. And that drive and that focus continued to open portals. I didn't know I wanted to be a filmmaker. I had no clue.
Okay.
No clue. Even going into the NFL, I just wanted to be the best player on the field. And lo and behold, as I'm playing, and, you know, you're stimulated by different things and different thoughts. I'm playing Max Payne, a video game, okay? I'm playing this video game, and I'm in this game. And I'm like, oh, man, this game feel real. I think I can write something like this. And I'll start playing this game, and this frivolous time and trivial time. And I'm sitting here thinking, like, I think I can write something like this. So after that, I'm like, I think I want to write a movie. I'm telling my boy, I think I want to write a movie. Like, I think I could write something like this. I might want to write a video game movie or something like that.
Yeah.
And it wasn't even, the film wasn't even a movie at the time. It was just a video game. So I started sparked a little interest in the offseason. A good friend of mine from Chicago that I went to Illinois with, Christopher Nolan from Chicago. Mm-hmm. He was like, Simeon, he was like, why don't you get with me? First, he asked me to invest in the film. I was like, I don't know anything about it. I'm not about to invest in no movie.
That's risky.
He was
okay,
like, Simeon,
yeah,
why don't we write one together? I'm like, me write a movie? He's like, yeah. And then I just kind of dictated the whole movie. And he was like, that's crazy. He's like, yo, you just dictated the whole flick? I'm like, yeah, it's just in my head. I mean, obviously, everything's in your head, but it wasn't hard for me to come up with it. In a two-hour setting, I was able to dictate a flick. You
wow.
know, and you have to, you have to start, like, creating structure. And I didn't know anything about script development or building structure. But I realized that was, like, kind of, like, gnarly. I felt like that was different.
Uh-huh.
And I'm like, okay, I just freestyled that film, like 2 hours. And then
freestyle
I started doing
film.
It.
That's
right.
A good
and I started
one.
Doing
yeah.
it all the time, like freestyling these, mm-hmm. these like stories in my head. And then all my teammates used to always like me to tell stories on the plane. So I'm like, maybe I could I should pin this.
There's
maybe
something
I should
there.
Start something there. Right. And thus it was birthed.
And you talked about too, this drive. I think that, where did that come from? I think it's
where
good.
Did the drive come from?
Yeah.
That's your inner spirit.
Yeah.
That's your inner spirit. Everything that we have, that we need, everything in this life we ever wanted, that we want to go after is inside of us. You know, not a lot of people test what we know. A lot of people know what to do. Very few people do what they know. You know, I've lived my life testing myself. I don't travel this world testing myself. I don't live like in the gridiron. You know, when you walk down that tunnel and you smell the barbecue, you look at the painted faces and you getting ready and everybody's shouting your name and you walk into that arena, you put a helmet on and you go back in time and you very like back in the Roman times, you in the Olympia
yeah.
and you testing what you're made of. My life has been that, you know, from getting outside of Southside Chicago, wanting to be better than I was. That's what it was. It was nothing really. It's always simplicity mm-hmm. in this most simplest form. It was just being better than I was. And I think I tap into that all the time. I tap into that. And my, like I said, those that know me that way.
Inspirational, Simeon. That's good stuff.
Yeah.
That's good stuff. I mean, I guess the last thing I want to ask you, you kind of touched on this earlier. Similarities between the NFL and movie making?
There's really no similarities.
Okay.
You know, you're dealing with, I mean, there's some, you know, in terms of, you know, working with a group and communicating. But you communicate from an athlete to an actor is totally different. Athletes are harsh and cold. This is what it is.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you go with the best people on the football field. In acting, you go with the best person for the role. They might not be the best actor in the room, but they're the best person that fits this script, this role, whatever. And you have to talk to them in such a way, you know?
Sure.
And
that
you have
makes
to
sense.
Do that in football, but it's a little bit more straightforward. They can take it.
Uh-huh.
The acting is in my head.
It's a little more.
What do you mean by this?
Yeah.
You know, what were you thinking? This is what
more,
I was thinking.
Yeah.
It's more subjective. It's
uh-huh.
more, you know, abstract, and it's, uh-huh. it's those type of things. But
okay.
This film comes out August 28th.
August 28th.
I mean, everybody, my Chicagoans, to stand up and go see this out. You know, this is a thrill ride of a film.
Definitely.
I'm a Southsider, like, you know, from Chicago. I need my Chicagoans to go out and represent in a big, big way.
What are you going to do while you're here? Anything?
Right now, I've been here for a while, so we, you know. I've been in Chicago for a minute. I come home. My parents still live here.
Okay.
So I make my rounds. I do the Mount Carmel thing. I always drive by my old neighborhood.
Nice.
Because I like to smell the air, you know.
It's different over there?
Then even if I don't eat Polish sausage, but I still might go buy one.
Hey, you know talking to Polish girls.
So, so it is what it is. You come back home and you do the Chicago thing.
Nice. No doubt. Good. Well, Simeon Rice, go see Unsullied August 28th.